Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easters Hills Crossroads in Indiana. Mobility is important. It's all about independence and being able to go where you want to go when you want to get there. Anna Leung on our staff here is going to show us some pretty cool technologies that help people who are blind or visually impaired navigate their physical environment.
Hi, my name is Anna Leung. I'm an assistive technology specialist at Easters Hills Crossroads. Today I would like to show you three GPS devices for the people who are blind or visually impaired. The first one is called the Tracker Breeze from Humanware. And then the second and the third one are two iOS apps for an iPhone. They're called the Locktail Breadcrumbs and the Seeing Assistant Alarm GPS. The Tracker Breeze uses digital geographical maps and to locate your position. And you can see this is the device. These maps are stored on SD cards that you can insert into the Breeze's allotted slot. It also lets you record routes and landmarks and guides you to an address. Let's take a look at the device. First, this middle button on the top is Where Am I button. And then the I button on the left states where GPS is available, the speed you're going, and how much the battery is charged. The arrow button at the lower right is to let you browse the routes recorded and select the route that you want. And then the button with a walking person at the lower left is to let you explore any GPS positions or landmarks recorded. The button with a red dot in the middle lets you record a route. Once you start recording, you can hit the round button above here to confirm that you're recording. While you're recording the route, you can also use the same record button to record a landmark. When recording, you just need to speak to the Breeze. Your voice will be recorded for the route and landmark you speak of. The Tracker Breeze comes with an SD card with maps, leather case with clip, shoulder strap, speaker with clip and cable, power adapter, USB PC cable, lanyard, companion CD including documentation and software, CD with audio user guide, and getting started on paper. It costs around $700 to $800. I found this quite easy to use and accurate. It works best when the location's global positions can be identified. However, if I record landmarks which are very close to each other, it might play a few of the recorded landmarks at the same time. For example, when I use it in a food court of a mall where there are several food stalls surrounding me, I might hear 2 to 3 landmarks for different restaurants I recorded. I also found that when it is really humid or has high precipitation, like today when it's snowing, the GPS cannot be found so easily, so it will not work well with such device. The second GPS device I want to show you is called the Locktail Breadcrumbs, and it is an iOS app that works well with iPhone 4 or 5 or above. It costs around $9.99, and I want to show you how it looks on the iPhone. It has an icon with a blue background and with a line of bubbles. So I'm going to hit it once to open it. Okay. And it works with the same concept as the Tracker Breeze. It lets you record routes and landmarks. Instead of calling it landmarks, it lets you drop breadcrumbs. So you can shake the phone to make it easy to drop any breadcrumbs, or you just simply hit the button on the right side, the middle section called Drop BC, and BC stands for drop breadcrumbs. So you can do it manually or you can just shake the phone. You can identify the closest breadcrumbs or how far each breadcrumb in clock positions away from you. And you can see at the upper right corner there's a button called Closest BC. You can also set up proximity radios to be alerted when these are close by. You can also find out the nearest address by latitude, longitude, and altitude. So, for example, if I hit women's room and try to find out how far women's room is from here, I hit the elongated button on the upper half, and it will show the address of the women's room, and it also set up with some accuracy and how far, in terms of altitude from you. So you can also hit the show map button to show where it is. But because the women's room is within the same building and there are several women's rooms here, and I recorded women's room on a lower floor, so that's why it's showing it's lower than me by 3 feet. So I'm gonna hit the close button. And you can also see the coordinates in the middle half of the screen where my phone is pointing at. Okay. And in my experience, if the BC are very close to each other, let's say within 10 feet, the closest BCs on the route will not be identified accurately one by one. And 10 feet is the shortest proximity radius you can set up. And so if you go to settings button, if you scroll down and can see the proximity radius, the next level is 10 feet, and I set that up as the lowest I can get. So for example, when I used it in a bookstore and drop BC in each section, such as the music section, the arts section, the bargain section, and the cashier sections, no matter how I moved my iPhone around within the sections, I was alerted more often by the BC for the cashier section, which was beyond 10 feet away from me. This made it ineffective when I use it to navigate among different sections in a close range. Okay. So the next app I want to show you is the Seeing Assistant Alarm GPS. And then the next one is it has an icon with like an eye in the middle. I'm going to touch it once to open it. Now this app costs around $1.99. It has a very strong signal to show you where you are. It allows one to set up several alarms based on the addresses identified by GPS. It lets you find other addresses and then add them as part of the alarm system. The alarm certainly goes off once the addresses are nearby within the distance you specify. However, it does not have the option to let you create route or alarm for objects or landmarks nearby. Also, it does not let one add alarm based on any measurement other than the addresses identified by the GPS. It is a great app in terms of identifying all the addresses around you, and you can see in the middle it shows you how fast you go and the course, whether you're heading north, south, east, or west, or how high in terms of the altitude. And the position right now is pointing at our home office address. And at the bottom, you can see there's an alarms button. If I hit it, it will give me a list of alarms. And then the third button is a settings button, and I can turn on or off the monitoring to have my address monitored every 30 seconds. If I go back, I can also set up default alarm settings to hear the alert within 20 yards or hear the alert within 3 miles. So there are all kinds of options I can set up in the settings tab. And then I go back to home tab. So it is a great app to constantly make you aware of where you are, but the fact that it will not let you set up alarm based on certain landmarks might make it difficult for one to learn how to go in between different destinations. So this is your tech tip of the day. Thank you for watching and listening.
So there are a few handy ways for folks who are blind or visually impaired to get around, go where they want to go. That's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.